All right, so differentiating my SMMA got me to consistent 60, 70K months at 23. I've been in the SMMA game for a little over 4.5 years now, and figuring out differentiation sucked. It took me like 2.5 years of testing and just getting rejected on sales calls to really get it. So, how do you differentiate your SMMA without burning 2.5 years? After my testing, I found there were really like five main ways to differentiate that I learned, and you might be thinking you know some of them just based on the names, but trust me, they go a lot deeper. And not knowing every single one of these in detail ended up costing me a lot of money. Like, genuinely, had I known all of these, I would have easily made an extra like 400K in the same amount of time, if not more. So if you don't want to make a 400K mistake, you should probably hear me out. Now, to get into the agenda, there are five key ways to differentiate here. This isn't all-encompassing, but these are the ones that I had learned personally. The first one is new pricing models. The second one is a functional benefit, and we'll get into it. This one goes a bit deeper as well. They all go a lot deeper. The third is time to result. The fourth is vehicle to result. And then the fifth is size of outcome. Again, you may think you have an idea based on names, but again, they do go deeper. Now, new pricing models. One of the biggest ways that you can differentiate yourself is by using a different pricing model from other people, and this is one of the big things that I did. So the class there's the classic flat fee retainer, right? At this point, that has been very heavily saturated, and it can still work, right? But some people will do a percentage of ad spend retainer. So for example, if you're managing an account that is spending, let's say, $100,000 a month on ads, you can charge 10% of that as your fee and charge them 10K per month. Some people use the pay in full model. That's what I personally use, and that's what was one of my key differentiating factors. Because a lot of people were focused on doing, flat fee retainers and this kind of thing when I started doing the pay in full model, and it just changed everything. Some people just work straight up on commission, so out of additional revenue that you make or additional profit that you make for the client, you take money out of that. There's pay per lead and pay per appointment, which is kind of like commission, but it's not necessarily on deals closed. It's on leads generated or appointments generated for them. Some people do a base plus pay per lead, a base plus pay per appointment. Some people even do a base plus a pay per close, that kind of stuff. Some people do a base plus a percentage of net profit. That's an option as well. But one of the biggest ways that you can compete is by having cheaper prices, lower prices. So your competitors do it for $500, you do it for $300. So what we're going to get into here with all of these different ways to differentiate is the more of them you use, the better, because now all of a sudden, it's not like you're just different in one little way. Because then people can say, oh, well, you're the same as everybody else. The only difference is, oh, I pay you differently, right? So you want to stack as many of these as possible within reason. You don't want to just do it for no reason. Like, and you need to understand that your entire business model changes based on your pricing model, how you get paid, when you get paid, how much you can get paid, etc. These all change based on the pricing model that you're using. And you can also create new pricing models. You don't need to create a new pricing model for the sake of it. There's a reason that all of these exist, and there's a reason that people use them. So you can leverage one of these, but you can look at which ones are oversaturated and which ones are less saturated. For me, the pay in full model had a lot of benefits, and a lot of people want pay in fulls, right? Who doesn't want to just get 5K in one shot, right? Now, the second thing I mentioned, functional benefit, actually, it's having a unique mechanism with a functional benefit. So what is a unique mechanism? In my own words, a unique mechanism is a part of your process or your whole process for delivering your service that is different, that is unique. Unique is one of one. It's completely different from anything else that's out there, or it's at least its own thing, right? And a mechanism is, again, that process, that system, that part of the process, whatever it is, that does something. It performs some act. Now, a functional benefit is, your unique mechanism will have some benefits that come with it, but what you want is to have an actual, like, functioning unique mechanism that does something, right? So you want to offer something new with a cool name, and a quick note on that for unique mechanisms, you want them to have a cool name. If they have a cool name, and I say a cool name, but a name that shows that it's different and that it's something new, right? That sounds good, not just the ABC system, right? But you want to offer something new with a cool name, yes, that actually provides an improved result, not just something that sounds cool. So you can have a unique mechanism that's just you've renamed the same shit that everybody else does. You've just slapped a new name on it, and wow, I'm so cool and different. If it has a functional benefit, it actually does something, right? So the unique mechanism in my business improves lead quality drastically. So there's an actual functional benefit to the unique mechanism. And if you pair these together, this is one of the biggest ways that you can differentiate your business from all of your competitors. Now, the next thing is time to result. So ask yourself right now, how long does it take for your clients on average to get the desired outcome from your service? The desired outcome, their desired outcome, the desired outcome that you advertise, whatever it is, how long on average, ask yourself honestly, does it really take? The next question is, how can you reduce this amount of time? How can you get them to that amount of money earned, or get them to that hire as fast as possible? And you want to reduce this latency, this time period, this lag as much as possible, because people will judge your solution based on how it compares speed-wise to other options in the marketplace. So the faster you can deliver the result, the better. Look at Amazon, they deliver overnight now, right? So the quicker you can get the people to the result, the better. This can be done in multiple ways. It's not just necessarily, you can increase somebody's ad budget to get them an ROI quicker. You can train somebody one-on-one or provide some type of, say, group coaching or something like this to your agency clients to teach them how to convert their leads so they can learn faster. You can install a calling team that calls their leads and books appointments for them to get them a bigger result, or just to get them that result faster, right? Now, the next thing is vehicle to result. And that in part can be the unique mechanism, but that's not really what I'm saying here. So think about how can you deliver the service in a new or different way, right? Or how do you do it, right? For me, I offer YouTube ads instead of Facebook ads. We're accomplishing the same thing, we're doing it in a different way, right? Everybody and their mom has a Facebook ads agency, so you offering YouTube ads allows you to stand out. It allows you to be different. You don't have to do it. I don't say that to scare you. I just say that was my thinking in switching over to the YouTube ads side of things. And similar to the unique mechanism with functional benefit, does your new or different delivery method solve a real problem, or are you just doing it for the hell of it? For example, Facebook ads, lead flow inconsistency. So people will sign up for Facebook ad agencies and they'll get a bunch of leads and then it'll fall off and die. And fatigue kicks in and the agency owner has no idea how to deal with ad fatigue and blah, blah, blah. So with YouTube ads, you can get much more consistent lead flow for your clients. So that's a real problem that it solves, right? Or for example, using landing pages instead of using on Facebook lead forms. Landing pages will get you higher converting, higher quality leads than on Facebook lead forms will, unless you're stacking those forms like crazy and doing a bunch of crazy stuff, which even then, a landing page will still generally give you higher conversion rates just because of the amount of friction involved. So it's not just what ad platform are you using, it's think about every single little, sub point of your process, of your delivery, service delivery system method, etc. Right? Landing pages versus lead forms, Facebook ads versus YouTube ads, video ads versus picture ads. Think of all these different things. What are the different ways that you can do this? One of the things that I've done is put the client on video after the lead signs up to introduce them, which warms up the lead some more. So like my whole thing is lead quality, and I've done a million things to stack lead quality, and then one of those bits or pieces of the puzzle, I've given a cool name, which has a really big impact on lead quality as a whole, and that's my unique mechanism. So there are a bunch of different vehicles to get to the result, and you can play around with these a lot and provide some very different things. The next one is size of outcome. So Can you increase the result or improve the outcome the person, your client, gets with your service? So, for example, if you're serving med spas, can you increase the med spa owner's revenue with the exact same ad spend? Or can you do it with more ad spend, but the same retainer, right? So you're charging them the same amount, but they're paying double to the ads, so they're able to get double the result. Is that possible, and can you do that without increasing your operational complexity and without increasing your costs? Because if so, then they can get better results. They can get more results, right? And then when they get more results, you're more likely to get referrals, testimonials, case studies, blah, blah, blah. Or for example, can you run a side campaign to the contract, to, let's say you're serving general contractors, can you run a side email campaign to their list to get them more jobs with $0 spent on ads? All you have to do is get a list from them, send an email blast out, that's 7 days, and then boom, you know, that, like, honestly, that could be as simple as sending an email, hey, do you know anybody who's looking for, you know, plumbing work to be done, or who needs plumbing work to be done? And then all of a sudden, you send one email to, let's say it was 350 people, and all of a sudden you have four more jobs that you just got for the guy within the first 7 days of service, right? Like, that's a really cool little thing that you can do that increases the size of outcome, and it also actually decreases the time to outcome for them, right? But for the sake of talking about size of outcome, having a bigger outcome allows you to charge more or just simply beat competitors who have the same pricing model as you do, right? Let's say you're $1,000 a month, they're $1,000 a month. You're saying that this person can add $10,000 a month to their business from ads. They're saying this person can add $10,000 of business a month to from their ads, right? But here you're like, I also have this campaign where in the first week, on average, it gets you five jobs if you have over 200 people that, you know, clients that you've worked with in the past. Well, all of a sudden, you know, provided all else is equal between you and your competitor, you will win. That's not exactly how it works. There are differences between you and them, and there always will be, but you get the idea, right? So again, the more of these, the better, to an extent. You don't want to just do these for the sake of doing them and slap them in there and do all this craziness and cause yourself a bunch of problems in the process and increase operational complexity and so on and so forth. But, you know, if you can run an extra side campaign to get them more results in the first week, if you can, you know, solve a real problem through some little thing within your delivery method, like adding video to make leads warmer and warm them up to the person, and if you can have them spend more money on ads with the same retainer to you, which is kind of the same as size of outcome but still time to result, then you're able to get them results quicker. And then also, if in your process you give one of those bits or pieces a good name and it actually solves a real problem, even better. Because now, unique mechanism, again, the word unique. And then finally, if you use it, you could even use a simple plain old pricing model at that point, and you've differentiated across four of these different planes. I don't think that's the right word. My mind is drawing a million blanks today. But you get the idea. Now you can really, really stand out. So the more of these, better, the better, to an extent. All right, now, if you want more personalized help on implementing all of this in your agency, because it's hard to take a YouTube video and actually make it happen, and, you know, there are a bunch of gaps in your knowledge, etc. If you want to work with me more closely, you can book a sales call with me in the description. There's a small group of us that are working together, agency owners, like-minded people, just collaborating and growing. Again, if you want to work with me more closely, you can book a sales call below. Otherwise, click whatever's popping up on screen, and I'll see you there.